Medication is for your own good.
Let's not have a repeat of yesterday.
No.
Give me that.
No.
Now open your mouth. There.
That wasn't so difficult, was it?
Screwdriver. Box.
let's start recording. Today's date, November 14th. Patient number 6079. Let's run the cognitive tests again. Your progress will be monitored through the sensors on your headset. I know this is uncomfortable, but bear with me. Listen to the words I read out and visualize the meaning. Ready? Ball. Swan. Screwdriver. Box. Boy. Medication. Fork. Mirror. Lamp. Toy. Photograph. Confession. Fuse. Genesis. Paradise. Murder.
Positive results. The readouts confirm that the patient is showing signs of memory. The patient understands.
I know that you understand why you're here. You came here looking for your brother, but it had been so long he'd already forgotten. When you got back, he saw the newspapers. He recognized the hero, missing in action. I saw it in him. A tiny spark that triggered something from a lifetime ago. He held on as that spark flickered. He held on as it began to illuminate the things he'd lost since he'd come. The only past he knew is this institution. It's all he should have remembered. We saw when he tried to contact you. We saw that he wasn't prepared to forget as he abandoned the second chance that I gave him. After the storm, he was one of the vulnerable left to fend for themselves. One of the children lost in a system which doesn't have enough money to provide for them. All too often, they end up back where they started, earning however they can, and persistently, they bring more lies into the very system that has already failed them. By offering him and others a clean start, away from this swamp, away from their past. You came here, the war hero back from the dead. You brought the media to find what was left of your family. It was you who put my work here under the spotlight. And it was you who left me no other option. By coming here, you killed your brother. The media didn't take long to turn on a survivor-turned-murderer. The worst kind of monster. One incapable of accepting their own actions. One who was safer here than anywhere else. I feel sorry for you. I gave you the chance to forget the loss that you've endured. I have tried to unburden you. I'd like you to prepare the patient for sedation. What's the problem? Is the door jammed?